Here we're going to graph the function sine x. Now, because this is the first trig function we're going to graph, I want to talk about a connection that we're going to be making use of quite a bit. And that's that what we're going to be doing is we're going to be creating a graph down here, but we're going to be using the circle to generate the graph. And every time we draw an angle on the circle, like for example, let's say I draw in a 30 degree angle, like so. Now, a 30 degree angle we know is pi over 6, right? So that angle is going to actually show up on the horizontal axis here. So pi over 6, if we say 0 is at the origin, pi over 6 is going to be located here. So pi over 6 is an angle you move to the right on the horizontal axis to indicate a counterclockwise direction rotation of pi over 6. And likewise, if you rotate another 30 degrees up to 60 degrees, let's draw that in. So this will be the rotation of pi over 3, right? So this is pi over 3, 60 degrees. That's going to be another movement to the right. That'll be right here, pi over 3. And if you go another 30 degrees, that's going to be 90 degrees. So that'll be here, that is pi over 2, right? And that would correspond to a rotation all the way 90 degrees. And you could keep going. If you rotate all the way over, that's pi, that's going to be way over here, right? Now you can also rotate the other way, though. You can also rotate in the clockwise direction. Now these angles would be negative, right? Let's say you rotated negative 30 degrees. That would be down here, let's say. So that rotation would be not positive pi over 6, but negative pi over 6. Now that's going to correspond to the point over here, that is movement to the left. So negative pi over 6. And if you go if you now go another 30 degrees rotating in the clockwise direction, so that'll be negative 60 degrees, that'll be negative pi over 3, and that'll be over here, right? Negative pi over 3. So what we're seeing is that every time, for every angle, that is, whether it's positive or negative, you have a corresponding point on the horizontal axis, positive or negative, okay? So that's the first connection, that rotations are going to actually be giving rise to coordinates on the horizontal axis. So this is the angle theta, whereas the rotation theta is the angle on the unit circle, or on the circle. Okay, with that in mind, let's go ahead and see how to graph the sine function. Okay, so here's the graph we're going to end up with, okay? And you can see that I have this horizontal axis with the angles, just like we talked about. So we're going to create those angles in this circle here. Now we're graphing on the y-axis. The y-coordinates are going to be sine of theta. Now remember that sine of any angle, sine of theta, is defined to be y divided by r. Now you can choose any r you want. I'm going to choose r to be equal to 1. That is, I'm going to be working with what's called the unit circle. Okay? So here's what we're going to do. We're going to create angles and then find out for those angles what y divided by r is. Now, there are certain angles that are really easy to work with. And those would be, for example, the first one would be the angle of 0. The next one would be the angle of pi over 2, so rotating all the way to pi over 2. And I'm going to need the coordinates of that point, so I'm drawing in the point now. Then the angle of pi, right? I'm going to need those coordinates. And how about 3 pi over 2? And then finally 2 pi. Now the coordinates of this point, remember, it's a unit circle, so r is 1. So that means the x coordinate is 1 and the y coordinate is 0. So 1 comma 0 for this point right here. This point would have coordinates x is 0 and y is 1. This point, x is negative 1 and y is 0. And this point, x is 0 and y is negative 1. Okay? Now, that means, for example, that sine of 0 degrees, right? Sine is the y-coordinate of the point divided by r. Now, I'm choosing r to be 1, so it's the y-coordinate, which is 0, divided by the r, which is 1, and 0 divided by 1 is 0. So when the angle is 0, sine is 0, right? It's 0 over 1. Okay, let's go on to pi over 2. Well, that's this rotation all the way up here, right? And the y-coordinate is 1 at that point up here. And the r is 1 as well, so 1 over 1 is 1. So when the angle's pi over 2, sine of pi over 2 is 1. Draw on that point, maybe right there. Let's go on to the angle of pi. That corresponds to the rotation all the way over here, right? The y-coordinate is 0. The r is 1, so 0 divided by 1 is 0 again. Okay, now you go to 3 pi over 2, all the way over here. Y is negative 1, r is 1. So negative 1 divided by 1 is negative 1. So maybe this point right here. And then finally at 2 pi, you're up here, or you're all the way over like this. And 0 divided by 1 is 0. Now you can also go the other direction, right? Negative pi over 2. That would correspond to a negative 90 degree rotation. Y is negative 1 and r is 1. So negative 1 divided by 1 is 1. So when the angle is negative pi over 2, sine is negative 1, right? Negative 1 divided by 1. And keep going, right, to negative pi. So it's rotating all the way around like this. Y is 0, r is 1. And so 0 divided by 1 is 0. Now, as you fill in more points, right, what's going to happen is you're going to get more, as you choose more angles, you're going to get more data points, and they're going to look like this eventually. So you're going to create this wave-like motion when you get more and more points. And similarly, going the other way, right? We're going to fill in more points, and we're going to get this. And that's going to be the graph of sine. Sine's going to look like this wave. It's going to keep going infinitely far in both directions, okay? I'm only graphing a little bit of that wave, but it keeps going, right? So it's this long, long wave. Okay, let's go ahead and pick some angles that'll help us get that resolution. So between 0 and pi over 2, that is between 0 and 90 degrees, let's pick some angles. How about like 30 degrees? Now 30 degrees, right, if you draw that in, that's pi over 6. Let's go ahead and do that. So there's an angle of 30 degrees. Let's drop a perpendicular so we can think about our little triangle here. So this is 30 degrees, and this is 60, and this is 90. Now we know if the hypotenuse is 1, that the coordinates of this point, well, the x-coordinate is long, right, because it's opposite 60. So the x-coordinate is root 3 over 2, but the y-coordinate is 1 half. So I can see that, remember, sine of 30 degrees is the y, 1 half, divided by the r, which is 1. So sine of 30 degrees is 1 half. So now 30 degrees in here, if this is 90 degrees, let me divide this interval into three pieces. Right, because if I divide 90 into 3, each of those is 30. So let's see, maybe right there. Okay, so this is 30 degrees, so that's pi over 6. And this is pi over 3, which is 60 degrees. Okay, so we said sine of 30 degrees, that is sine of pi over 6, is 1 half. So when the angle is pi over 6, the sine of that angle is 1 half. So this is about 1 half, right? Okay, what about for an angle of pi over 3? Now that would be 60 degrees. So we draw that like so. Okay, and then I draw my triangle just like I did a moment ago. Okay, yet the reference angle, this angle is 60 degrees. So this point has coordinates. Well, now that value is small, so it's 1 half. But the y coordinate's large, right? It's root 3 over 2. Now that means sine of 60 is root 3 over 2 divided by 1, which is just root 3 over 2. So that's a pretty large number, right? We're really getting up there. So that might be, you know, when the angle's pi over 3, we're getting closer to 1. Not quite there, but we're getting closer. So maybe right there, just below 1. Now you can see what's happening, right? The y-coordinate is going from 0 to 1 half, root 3 over 2. The y-coordinate's getting large. Look at that. And the y-coordinate peaks at 1. And as you get beyond pi over 2, what happens? Well, the y-coordinate starts falling. It falls from 1, and the y-coordinate falls all the way to 0. Okay, the y-coordinate's getting smaller as you go from pi over 2 to pi. So you can see that's happening here, right? As the angle goes from pi over 2 to pi, we know that because the y-coordinate's dropping, sine is going to be dropping, so it's going to look like that. And it's going to look symmetric. It's going to drop in the same way that it rose a moment ago, right, from 0 to pi over 2. So the other part of the curve is going to look like this. Now, what happens once you get beyond pi, from pi to 3 pi over 2? Well, it looks like sine is going to be negative. Let's verify that. So between pi and 3 pi over 2, that would be between, let's see, pi and 3 pi over 2. And you can see all the y-coordinates are going to be negative, right? Like, for example, if I draw in a 30-degree angle here, let's do that now, maybe like that, and I draw my little triangle. Here, this is 1. Now, what are the coordinates of this point if this is 30 degrees? Well, the x-coordinate would be negative root 3 over 2. Negative 3 over 2. And the y-coordinate, right, that's this, that's going to be negative 1 half. So the y-coordinate is negative. Now, what's this angle all the way down there? Remember, 30 degrees is pi over 6. So it'd be pi plus pi over 6, which is 7 pi over 6. So I'm talking about the angle just beyond pi, right? 30 degrees beyond pi. So that's going to be like maybe right here. That's going to be 7 pi over 6. So in the angle 7 pi over 6, I can see that sine is negative 1 half divided by 1, which is negative 1 half, right? Which is why the value is going to be way down here. Right, negative 1 half. And you can see what's going to keep happening. The y-coordinate's going to keep dropping, right? The y-coordinate 0, negative 1 half. It's going to keep dropping until it gets to negative 1. And then it's going to start rising again back to 0. Now, it's going to drop all the way. Sine's going to drop all the way to negative 1 and then rise back up until sine of the angle is 0 here. So let's go ahead and fill those points in. Get more and more data points to see what the first cycle of sine looks like. Let's do that now. Okay, so this is one cycle of sine. Now, we say one cycle of sine when the graph is about to start repeating, right? So if I keep going beyond 2 pi, I can see that it's going to keep rising, and I'm going to get the same shape again, right? The wave is going to be repeating. Now, from 0 to 2 pi, we say that this is one period. So how far you have to go to get repetition, that's called a period. So the period is, in this case, 2 pi. You have to go all the way to 2 pi for sine to keep repeating. Now, we can also go the other way, right? That is, the angle can be negative. So if you go from 0 to negative pi over 2, I can see right away sine is going to be negative because the y-coordinate is going to be negative. So the y-coordinate hits its most negative value at negative pi over 2, negative 1, and then it rises back up to 0. So the graph is going to look like this now, right, as I make my way through negative angles. Let's go ahead and fill in that part of the curve now. Okay, so there we go. And it would continue in this direction, right? The wave continues. Now, I can see from this graph that the domain, right, that is what I can plug in along the horizontal axis, I can plug in whatever I want. So it's going to be negative infinity to infinity. That is, you can plug in any angle you want. But the range, clearly the function, the outputs don't get below negative 1, nor do they rise above positive 1. So the range is just from negative 1 to positive 1. Okay, so one final note, and it's that I've graphed sine of theta. Now, I wrote here sine of x. It turns out when we write sine of x, we really mean the x is an angle, okay? So people don't write sine of theta very often. Usually they write sine of x, and you just have to know that this x really means theta. Those are the same thing. You have to remember that x is not the same thing as this x, okay? This x is the angle because we're taking sine of that angle. Don't confuse it with the x-coordinate that corresponds to the angle. You just have to keep those straight. So this is the graph of sine theta or sine x, however you want to look at it. And in the next video, we'll go ahead and graph cosine using a similar method. Until next time.